Breaking news just moments ago on day 13 of the shutdown. The House passed a package of bills that would end the shutdown, but without money for the president's wall. President Trump tonight promising a veto, though. While Speaker Pelosi makes it really clear that she is not going to budge on the wall.
Anyway. We're not doing a wall. Does anybody have any doubt that we're not doing a wall?
So here we are on the very first day of the new Congress. Nancy Pelosi, President Trump going toe-to-toe. Remember way back in December, just 3 weeks ago, when the president said this?
I am proud to shut down the government for border security, Chuck. I will take the mantle. I will be the one to shut it down. I'm not going to blame you for it.
So much for proud. So much for blaming the Democrats. Now it's all veto threats for this president, with day 14 of the shutdown just hours away. So much for not blaming the Democrats, I should say. But as of today, it's a whole new world. A world where President Trump doesn't control Congress. A world where he can't rely on his own party to push through his agenda. A world where he can't bully Congress into giving him exactly what he wants. Because when Nancy Pelosi retook the gavel today, when Democrats took control of the House, they ushered in the most diverse Congress in history. The pictures, these right here, tell the story. Look at that. The old guard, mostly men in dark suits, on one side. And on the other side, diversity on display. People of color, women and men, LGBT people, old and young. This is what America looks like. And here's another picture that shows you the diversity of this new Congress, okay? Take a look at this. An array of holy books for the swearing in of the new members. Like I said, it's a whole new world right now. And looming on the horizon, a lot of dark clouds for President Trump. Speaker Pelosi refusing to rule out the possibility of impeachment or indictment.
We shouldn't be impeaching for a political reason, and we shouldn't avoid impeachment for a political reason. So we just have to see how it comes.
Could Robert Mueller come back and say, I am seeking an indictment?
I think that that is an open discussion. I think that is an open discussion in terms of the law.
Open discussion. Remember, there are no fewer than 17 investigations of just about every aspect of this president's life, from his campaign, to his administration, to his allies, to his businesses. And it's no coincidence that top Democrats on the Judiciary Committee introduced a bill today to protect Special Counsel Robert Mueller from being fired by President Trump. That, as the same committee is trying to get Acting Attorney General Matt Whitaker to answer their questions about protecting Mueller.
Still trying to get a date. And they're dragging their feet on a date. We'll see what happens.
Will you send a subpoena to him if he doesn't?
You could if we have to.
And then there's the question of the president's tax returns. Senate Finance Committee ranking member Ron Wyden introducing a bill today requiring the president to make his returns public, which he obviously won't do without a fight. And here's something else that may have this president spooked. The thing he has counted on to be the force field around his presidency. Wall Street. Look at those numbers. The Dow took another nosedive today, falling 660 points, its biggest percentage drop since 2013. That's after a roller coaster December, its worst since the Great Depression. On just the second trading day of the month, President Trump tweeted that he is a tariff man, seeming to completely misunderstand the fact that a tariff is a tax on imports, one that raises prices for, you guessed it, consumers. And the Dow dropped nearly 800 points. On Christmas Eve, the president tweeted an attack on the Fed, and the Dow lost 653 points, the biggest Christmas Eve decline in history. So, yeah, the market looks like it's no longer the bright spot it used to be for this president. All of this with no end in sight to the shutdown, as the president seems to be willing to stake everything on his wall, a wall to keep immigrants out. But there's another president who might have seen all of this very differently.
Let us remember what President Reagan said in his last speech as President of the United States. He said,
"If we ever closed the door to new Americans, our leadership in the world would soon be lost."
Ronald Reagan. You want to applaud for Ronald Reagan?
That's a fair question. Every American should applaud President Reagan's words. He stood up for the values that truly make America great. Values like welcoming people from around the world to be part of the American dream. And this president, resorting to stunts like this. A suddenly announced press briefing that in the real world was nothing more than the sad president trying to take back the spotlight from Nancy Pelosi and the new Congress. Come on. Contrast President Reagan's wise words with this president's empty threats, random tweets, and memes. But you know what? It's going to take a lot more than memes, and stunts are not going to cut it. This president has the bully pulpit. Nancy Pelosi has the gavel. America is waiting to see who gets the last word.